Hello, I'm Akriti Agarwal, Labels and Labeling Editor for India and Southeast Asia. Today, I'm in conversation with Mr. Shivam Hora, Marketing Associate for Hora Art Press, based out of Noida.
Today, we're going to learn a little bit about how our company works and what all machines that we have and how we exactly bounce back from the shortcomings of coronavirus pandemic and the lockdown. When anyone enters, they are supposed to sanitize their hands and we check their temperature with a thermal gun. Let me show you. If someone enters a company who has fever or cough or any one symptom, we tell him to wait in the isolation room till we can call for medical help. This is our isolation room. And I would prefer that we do not enter it because it's just for anyone with symptoms. The area that we have specially designed for our Konica Minolta press. You can see some of our jobs. I'll just show it to you. We print such warning labels with ease on this machine, and it's very convenient to do so. Some of the other products here, and abhi kya print ho raha hai ispe? Energy label. So these are some of the energy labels that we're printing on this machine. It gives perfect colors, and our customers are truly satisfied. And these are some of the recent jobs that we've done. We specifically created this area for a good, perfect customer experience, that anyone who has any interest in this press can come and see and learn more about it, because we truly believe that Konica gives one of the best customer experiences, and we are an example of that. So Mamaearth, as I told you, we print Mamaearth on Konica. So this is our Flexo area, and this is our Flexo press. These are for companies such as Panasonic, LG and Mamaearth. So huge quantities of Mamaearth we print from Flexo. However, mostly all the Mamaearth jobs are done on Konica. Everyone's wearing mask, as you can see, and yeah. Mainly we are into labels. However, this is our offset area for other jobs. So now I will bring you to the finishing area. This is a slitting machine, an EVT. And these are die cutting machines.
What steps has the company taken to run operations with reduced manpower and capacity?
Okay, so initially, when the lockdown ended and when we were instructed to open our company, we didn't have many orders, and the orders that we did have were of basically the necessity items, such as sanitizers or food items or basically labels for jam jars and all that. So instead of going for full capacity production on Flexo or offset, we went for digital production, and even at a slightly higher rate, the customers were very happy and glad to pay for it, because that meant timely delivery as well as very ease in checking and everything. So it was convenient for them as well as us.
With lockdown opening now in most parts of the country, do you see the market demand going back to what it was back in February? When do you think will the market bounce back?
So in this context, it would be unfair to talk about just the printing industry, because the market has been affected in totality. So a lot of people, like every business, is suffering. I don't know about other companies, but in our company, the demand sort of bounced back within the first 2 months of the lockdown opening. So by the first unlockdown, which was the unlockdown one, our company had reopened, and the demand was back to where it was earlier. So in my opinion, for the printing companies, the demand is right back where it used to be. However, I can't say the same about other businesses.
what support did you get from your suppliers when your presses were sitting idle for weeks and then you had to restart them?
The companies that we take our papers from and the companies that we get our inks from were really helpful and were really happy to help, as they understood the importance of maintaining good relations with their vendors. And I should really mention the companies that we have imported our machines from, which is Konica. So as soon as our company opened, Konica offered free maintenance services, and it made sure that our presses were ready to run and everything was tip-top before we could start production.
Give us the details about how digital technology helped you run operations during the pandemic, and how did you manage to procure paper and ink and manage other logistics without much hassle during the lockdown?
Okay, so initially, as I had mentioned earlier, as soon as our company reopened, we did not bounce back to offset and flexo, because that took a lot of setup time and a lot of costs, and our customers wanted their their printed materials, such as labels and all, in a shorter time. So we went to digital very initially, and as I said, the companies that we own the machines of were really helpful and made sure that we could run productions with ease.
While I do understand that digital has its own benefits, but can you tell us about any one challenge that you faced while running digital press, and how did you overcome it?
So as soon as the lockdown opened, digital was a blessing, and it really helped us counter all the offers that were of the short run, because 90% of our orders as soon as the company reopened were short runs. However, within the first month of the lockdown reopening, the big orders started coming in, and then we had to think a little bit about going back to flexo and offset. But till the point we were ready to translate to flexo and offset, we were comfortably using the digital printing presses.
How has Konica Minolta Press assisted in combating counterfeiting and helping you manage supply chain challenges?
This reminds me of a small instance from the past, which is not after the lockdown, but like maybe last year that was. So a sanitizer company came to us and told us that its labels were being counterfeited, like around 70% of its labels in the market and 70% of its bottles in the market were with the fake labels. So it came to us and we gave it a solution in which it could have a variable printed barcode at the back of the label. I'm sorry, I can't really tell you the name of the company because I don't think that's allowed. But yeah, so through the Konica Digital Press, we could help them out with this problem. And I don't know the data if the counterfeiting has reduced, but they are for sure a regular customer with us since then.
Appreciate all your frank responses, and thank you so much for your time.